brothers and sisters, to increase your iman. Read the miracle, recite the Qur'an. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Qur'an are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span, sent from Allah to an angel then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi wa kafa wa salamun ala ibadihi alladhina astafa. La siyama al-Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallama tasliman kathira. Dear viewers everywhere, I'd like to welcome you to another live edition of your program, Correct Your Recitation. I'd like also to welcome our studio guests. Assalamu alaikum, Izzat, Umar, Ibrahim,
Fahim.
Barakallah feekum and thank you for joining us. Barakallah feekum. Inshallah, today we will begin from ayah number 20. Through ayah number 26, that is page number 509 in the Mus'haf of the Medina complex for printing the Qur'an. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها إن الذين ارتدوا على أدبارهم بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى الشيطان سول لهم وأملى لهم ذلك بأنهم قالوا للذين كرهوا ما نزل الله سنطيعكم في بعض الأمر والله يعلم إسرارهم.
In ayah number 19, which we finished in the previous episode, فَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was addressed in this ayah and the believers as well. And the order is very important. العلم, then العمل. فَعْلَمْ, which means get to know that, learn that, comprehend that there is no ilah but Allah. Then wastaghfir li dhanbika wa lil mu'minina wal mu'minat. And that's called what? Amal, an action. So the right order is al-ilm, then al-amal. Then the following ayat are very exposing, because he will disclose the reality of the munafiqeen. Hypocrisy is one of the worst diseases. And hypocrisy when it comes to faith, its punishment is worse than disbelief. Because their harm is much greater than the harm of the disbelievers. When I know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّ الشَّيْطَانَ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ فَاتَّخِذُوهُ عَدُوًّا يَا بَنِي آدَمَ أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ When Allah the Almighty says, أَلَمْ أَعْهَدْ إِلَيْكُمْ أَلَّا تَعْبُدُوا الشَّيْطَانَ إِنَّهُ لَكُمْ عَدُوٌّ مُبِينٌ I know that Satan is my enemy. Right? And that's why whenever we fall into sins or mistakes, we say it's because of Satan. We say so. Not necessarily all the time that it's because of the whispers of a shaitan. It could be because of the hawa, because of the desire, the whim. But the problem is, whenever there is an enemy within, and the enemy is concealed, or you don't have the power to disclose him, you have a feeling that this person is a munafiq. But you're not allowed to say that he's a munafiq. Because nifaq, hypocrisy in faith or belief, is worse than disbelief. Allah the Almighty says in Surah An-Nisa, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ وَلَنْ تَجِدَ لَهُمْ نَصِيرًا There are many ayat that describe the fate of the disbelievers. But this ayah is very powerful in describing that the fate of the munafiqeen is way worse than the disbelievers. They will not be just treated as disbelievers. They are disbelievers because they conceal disbelief. But their punishment is much worse than the punishment of the disbelievers. So he said, verily, the hypocrites will be في الدرك الأسفل من النار in the bottom of hell. On top of them will be the kuffar and the criminals, but they will be on the bottom. The worst place in hell is booked for the munafiqeen. They are sleepers. They're waiting for the right time to expose their disbelief. Such as whenever the Prophet ﷺ heard that the Meccans are about to attack Al-Madinah. After the Prophet ﷺ and the 314 companions utterly defeated the Meccan army of 1,000 or so. You know? So the Meccans came to take revenge a couple of years later in the Battle of Uhud. Now with an army of 3,000. The Prophet ﷺ consulted his companions. And when I say his companions, he would consult those who are sitting in the masjid. So there are people who are not truly Muslims. We know some of them by the name, such as Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, who was known as the head of the Munafiqeen. And it was not only one or two or three, there are many of them. Initially, they had a different view when the Prophet ﷺ adopted the view of the vast majority and they decided to go out to defend Al-Medina. Not to wait until the Meccans enter Al-Medina, then they confront them within the city. So while on the way to the site of the Battle of Uhud, in front of the mountain of Uhud, Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul withdrew along with how many? One third of the Muslims' army, 300 munafiq. This is a time to expose the reality of those people. As I said, they are sleepers. So if there is gain, they say, where is our share? But if there is a disaster, say, it's over. Finally, you got rid of them. And they say that to the kuffar, we are with you. We are amongst you. We belong to you. وَإِذَا خَلَوْا إِلَىٰ شَيَاطِينِهِمْ قَالُوا إِنَّا مَعَكُمْ إِنَّمَا نَحْنُ مُسْتَهْزِئُونَ So in private, they say to their gangsters and their company, we are with you. We're only pretending to be Muslims. We're not. We're only mocking at the Muslims. That is called the enemy within. So the following ayat, along with similar ayat in Surah An-Nisa, expose the reality of the sect, the worst enemy, the enemy within, the fifth column, and also those who assist them directly or indirectly. Let's see ayah number 20. Will classify people according to the benefit they get from the Qur'an into two categories. are the believers who are anxiously waiting for the wahy. And whenever a revelation would come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, they would celebrate and say, what is it? Then immediately they say, sami'na wa ata'na, we heard and we obeyed. This is the attitude of the believers. What about the other party, the munafiqeen? They put their hands on their heart, they're afraid. Maybe there is another command, there is another order, there is another prohibition. We're not ready to comply because they don't know why. They are not believers. In the case of prohibiting drinking, Anas ibn Malik radiyallahu anhu narrated that it was only when Allah the Almighty says, Ya ayyuha alladhina amanu innama al-khamru wal-maisiru wal-ansabu wal-azlamu rijusun min amal al-shaytani fajitanibuhu. So avoid it. Avoid drinking, avoid gambling, avoid this and that. He said, what did they do? He said that some of the companions have left the cup of the wine in his mouth, he was drinking. And the caller of the Prophet ﷺ was running in the streets of Al-Madinah, going around saying, Allah has forbidden Al-Khamr. And he quotes the ayah, Innama Al-Khamr wal-Maisar. So he said, they dropped it. An innocent comply. They did not say, for instance, let me finish this sip, this cup, or this drink. No. فَاجْتَنِبُوا, so avoid it. And they innocently comply. But the attitude of the munafiqeen, number one, they say, what does Allah mean with that? What does the Prophet mean with that? They were all among the audience, but they do not comprehend the word of Allah and His Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Either because, as Allah the Almighty will say in this, in the chapter, in ayah number 24, أَفَلَا تَذَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا. When they comprehend and ponder over the Qur'an, they don't understand it. Or their hearts are locked up. And in fact, their hearts are locked up. So they do not benefit whatsoever from a dhikr, from the revelation. So this ayah does exactly the following. It exposes the reality of the munafiqeen. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَتْ سُورَةً. The believers constantly say, why isn't it a surah been revealed? To do what? To give us the permission, to give us the command to fight against the disbelievers. This statement had been said even before the migration. Abdurrahman ibn Auf and many other companions would come to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and say, Ya Rasulullah, whenever we were non-believers, idolaters, we were in izzah, no one would dare to lift a finger or talk to us in a humiliating way. No one would dare to hurt us. And now, after we recognize the truth and accepted Islam, we are being persecuted. How come? Why? Because they begged the Prophet ﷺ to fight back. But Allah did not allow them to fight back. Did not allow them to defend themselves in Mecca for 13 years. Mecca is baladun haram. Is a sacred city. Imagine if we open a series of bloodshed and killing in Mecca. In addition to the Muslims' number, was still very little. This Muslim party could have been eliminated, eradicated, slaughtered. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all wise. He would not rush because they are asking for it. Then when they immigrated to Al-Madinah, now Allah the Almighty gave them a permission, gradually. First of all, allowed them to defend themselves. أُذِنَ لِلَّذِينَ يُقَاتَلُونَ بِأَنَّهُمْ ظُلِمُوا وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ عَلَى نَصْرِهِمْ لَقَدِيرٌ. It has been given permission for those who have been fought against on account of their faith, those who have been oppressed and persecuted, now to defend themselves. And Allah is able to give them victory. Then Allah the Almighty says, وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَا يُحِبُّ الْمُعْتَدِينَ. Fight for the sake of Allah, in the sake of Allah, against those who fight against you. You know, Orientalists and those who are obsessed with the constant stereotyping of Islam and Muslims, they only take the first part. They call it a holy war. And if they bother to read in their holy books, you will be ashamed to share this with others. What their books are saying in this regard, it is their informations which call it a holy war. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, قَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَ لَكُمْ. Fight in the sake of Allah those who fight against you. وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا. Behold, do not aggress against others. Do not transgress against others, because Allah likes not the transgressors. So now, the believers were anxiously waiting for an ayah, for a revelation which would allow them to fight for the sake of Allah. But they couldn't do that on their own. They're waiting for the wahy. That's why they said, لَوْلَا نُزِّلَتْ surah. We wish that a surah would be revealed to give us the command to fight against these criminals, to show them bravery and courage. فَإِذَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ. And whenever Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent a surah in this regard, surah, here does not necessarily refer to a whole chapter. Ayat, talking about the mandate of jihad, fighting the cause of Allah against the criminals and against those who oppress Muslims. وَقَاتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ الَّذِينَ يُقَاتِلُونَكُمْ وَلَا تَعْتَدُوا. When these ayat are revealed, وَذُكِرَ فِيهَا الْقِتَالِ, and once the fighting and jihad is mentioned in it, رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَيْكَ نَظَرَ الْمَغْشِيَّ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْمَوْتِ فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ. When the ayat, when the chapter of the Qur'an is revealed to command jihad, those who's in their hearts, there is a disease. Who are they? The hypocrites. المنافقين. في قلوبهم مرض فزادهم الله مرضا. In the heart there is a disease, and Allah even increased their disease furthermore to be destructive, because they chose that. They're worse than the disbelievers. Those people in whose hearts there is a disease, you will see them ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليهم من الموت. Have you ever seen somebody who is dying? Have you seen somebody at the time of death, when he or she faints, نظر المغشي عليهم من الموت, when some people see something very horrifying and they fall apart, they fall unconscious? That's called نظر المغشي عليهم من الموت. They have seen death, so they fall unconscious. They faint out of fear of death. That is the reaction of the munafiqeen whenever the ayah is revealed to command fighting back, defending yourself, defending your faith, defending the believers, which is called jihad. But the munafiqeen are not ready for that. The munafiqeen will just enjoy the free ride, you know, live happily amongst Muslims, enjoy the kind treatment, but they don't want to do anything. That's why whenever al-ayatul amaliyya, the practical ayat, are revealed, because there are ayat which commands good faith, belief, and these are some things which, you know, everybody could claim. And that's why they're called munafiqeen. They say, نَشْهَدُ أَنْ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ إِذَا جَاءَكَ الْمُنَافِقُونَ قَالُوا نَشْهَدُ أَنَّكَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ وَاللَّهُ يَعْلَمُ إِنَّكَ لَرَسُولُ وَاللَّهُ يَشْهَدُ إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ لَكَاذِبُونَ. Okay, it's an easy statement. This is exactly what Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul, when did he accept Islam? Before the Battle of Badr, he was very aggressive, very insultive, very confrontational to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But after the Battle of Badr, and when he saw how Muslims are brave and courageous and utterly defeated their enemies, he was coward and he was afraid. So he came willingly and he accepted Islam, apparently. But inside his heart, he was one of the worst disbelievers. And Allah exposed his reality in many positions in the Quran. When? So those people, they have disease in their hearts. فَزَادَهُمُ اللَّهُ مَرَضًا. Whenever the ayah is revealed to give them practical jobs to do, action to do, they are very reluctant. They say, they start stuttering and say things like, why? Why did Allah reveal this ayah? What is the purpose? You find somebody said, Could you tell me why wearing gold is haram for men? What about silk? Could you tell me why pork is forbidden? Nowadays we raise the pigs in very nice farms and they're very well taken care of. You know, I have the answer to you. You want to know why Allah is forbidding gold for men? You want to know why Allah has forbidden silk for men? You want to know why Allah has forbidden eating pork? You know now what? You want to know why Allah has forbidden us from eating any meat which is not slaughtered in His name? Simply because Allah said so. That is the answer. And the reply of the believers, whenever Allah or His Messenger command a thing, what do they say? أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا. We obey and we hear. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, أثقل صلاتين على المنافقين الفجر والعشاء. Even in the ibadat, which, you know, bodily acts of worship, there is no jihad, there is no fighting, there is no giving money, the prayer. They do it because they have to attend, or otherwise they will be exposed. The Prophet ﷺ said, the most difficult prayer for the munafiqeen is Fajr and Isha. Why? Because it's in darkness, it's in cold, or while the person is asleep, and they are struggling to come to sign in and sign out. Not because they know that the angels are attending the recitation of the Qur'an, Allah is waiting for them in the masjid, Allah will grant them this reward. They don't buy any of that. It's simply sign in and out. Hey, I'm here. And that's why these two prayers are very hard for the munafiqeen. Too bad that they have to come back and forth, back and forth. And they will get no reward whatsoever, as Allah the Almighty said in the following ayah. Let's finish this ayah first. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ. What is the meaning of the word فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ? Have you heard this word before in any chapter of the Quran? أَوْلَى. Huh? أَوْلَى لَكَ فَأَوْلَى ثُمَّ أَوْلَى لَكَ فَأَوْلَى. It's repeated in Surah Al-Qiyamah and in Surah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And in Surah Al-Qiyamah is repeated how many times? أَوْلَى لَكَ فَأَوْلَى ثُمَّ أَوْلَى لَكَ فَأَوْلَى. What does it mean? It is from Al-Wail wa-Thubur, which is woe to them. Yeah, you can hide yourselves and your reality from people, not from Allah. So Allah is confronting them. Woe to you! Destruction be upon you. Al-Wail wa-Thubur. This is one meaning of the word فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ. Then the ayah stops at there, which means that the following ayah will have a new meaning that will be delivered, which is طَاعَةٌ وَقَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ. And that means those who would obey the command of Allah and they say what is good, obedience, and a good statement, a good reply, such as سَمِعْنَا وَأَطَعْنَا, Surah An-Nur. فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. الطَّاعَةُ وَالْقَوْلُ الْمَعْرُوفُ is better for them. Have they obeyed Allah and His command? Have they said what is good whenever they heard the order of Allah? It would have been much better for them because they would be rewarded, but they didn't. فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ, that means whenever the matter of jihad is resolved on. Now, the serious moment, we're confronting the enemies. There is no way of going back. But Abdullah ibn Ubay ibn Salul withdrew with 300 of his followers, leaving the Muslims' army with only 700 facing and confronting an army, well-prepared army of 3,000. فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ, when the matter of jihad is resolved on, فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ, if they had been true to Allah, not concealing disbelief and showing belief, if they were true in their faith, in their claim, it would have been better for them. Why? Because Khalid ibn al-Walid answered this question when the Persian emperor you know, asked him, why did he come here? And aren't you afraid of death? He said, we're only seeking one of two, either victory or martyrdom. So in either case, we're winners. If we die, we die for his sake. وَلَا تَحْسَبَنَّ الَّذِينَ قُتِلُوا فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ أَمْوَاتَ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ بَلْ أَحْيَاءٌ وَلَكِنْ لَا تَشْعُرُونَ. In one ayah, Allah the Almighty says that those who have been killed for his sake are alive, they are not dead, but you do not perceive their life, you cannot see it. And in another ayah, عِنْدَ رَبِّهِمْ يُرْزَقُونَ, they are alive with the Lord, being provided with the provision that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala prepared for them in heaven. Well, so this is a shahada or victory. So either way, we're winners. It would have been better for them, as Allah the Almighty said. So the second ayah, according to the earlier meaning which I shared with you concerning the last word of ayah number 20, فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ, if it means woe to them, then the ayah finished at that. The second ayah says, an obedience and a good statement saying, obey, and we heard and we obey, and really taking part in jihad against the enemies, it would have been better for them. There is another meaning to the word فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ. The word أَوْلَى in Arabic means
better.
Better. A better choice. It would have been better for them to obey and to listen to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to say what is good. And in this case, the following ayah, which is ayah number 21, is actually relating and connected to ayah number 20. فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ طَاعَةٌ وَقَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ. It would have been better for them. This matter is very important, but we ran out of time, so hopefully, inshallah, we'll get to continue with the same topic, inshallah, next week. But now we got to take a short break, and soon after the break, inshallah, we'll open the phone line for those who would like to recite the ayat from ayah number 20 through ayah number 26. Please stay tuned.
Recite it every day and do read it loud.
Huda TV's social media sites are the best way to contact us from anywhere around the world. Stay connected with Huda TV's latest news and programs through Facebook, Twitter, Google+, YouTube, Skype, and Instagram. It's fast and easy. Stay up to date with your favorite shows and scholars today. Huda TV, a light in every home.
Allah, so let me stray, please guide my way.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Welcome to another episode of Let's Talk on your favorite channel, Huda TV. I'm your host, Arkham Rashid. They actually did such and such that you're accusing him of in your mind. So now I want to start off with my right-hand side, Brother Ahmed. If you can just tell us what your thoughts were on that video, what can you extract from that video? Would you say some of the youth turn to drugs, especially, you know, in your country, if they don't have jobs, or, you know, it's because they want to get away from their daily normal lives? Would you say that's
okay,
a reason?
Absolutely, that's true. Some people just resort to drug as the last option because they get themselves straight out and they're instead of depression, but they don't know where to turn for help.
Sports per se is like a communal social activity, whereas it collects the community together and it bonds brotherhoods together, you know? It's very social in its aspect where you interact with, you know, your teammates or your players in a team.
So I think a message would be just to stay completely away from it. Even we can say, oh look, it's haram.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh, and welcome back. I guess I need to remind you with our phone numbers, which should appear on the screen, area code 002, then 0238555249, Alternatively, area code 002-011-25-00-8679. Email address is tajweed@huda.tv. While waiting for your calls, inshallah, we'll begin with our studio guest. Beginning from, may I skip you this time, Izzat, and I'll begin with Umar.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم.
Okay, Umar, جزاك الله خيرا. We'll pause here. Yeah. We'll continue, inshallah, after this call. Sister Aisha from the case, say, Assalamu alaikum.
How are you,
sir? Fine, alhamdulillah. Thank you for asking. From ayah number 20 of Surat Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, please.
ويقول الذين
ويقول الذين آمنوا
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المعشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم
Can you say again نظر المغشي عليه من الموت
نظر المعشي عليه من الموت
Go back to the word المغشي عليه because it's a غين not عين نظر المغشي عليه من الموت
نظر المعشي عليه من الموت
Can you say the غين by itself? Say غا
مغ مغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدون في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم
أولئك There's no noon in تفسدوا أن تفسدوا not تفسدون فهل عسيتم
فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها إن الذين ارتدوا على أدبارهم من بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى الشيطان سول لهم وأملى لهم ذلك بأنهم قالوا للذين كرهوا ما نزل الله سنطيعكم في بعض الأمر
حسبك بارك الله فيك سيستر عائشة from the KSA we have sister Basma from Egypt السلام عليكم
السلام عليكم
Welcome to the program, and go ahead and recite from number 20. ويقول الذين آمنوا.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة. فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها
حسبك سيستر بسمة بارك الله فيك جزاك الله خيرا very good ما شاء الله ريان from the case السلام عليكم ريان
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
how are you ريان
fine الحمد لله
great you know where to start from, right?
Yeah.
Okay, go ahead.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عصيتم أن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم
We prolong المد المنفصل if you remember okay read this ayah again anyway فهل عصيتم
أن توليتم
ريان عسى is different than عصى. عصى, if it is a verb, it means disobeyed or sinned. عصى, if it is a noun, it means it's a stick, like عصى موسى. And عسى with the seen, not with the صاد, means perhaps. Okay, so the seen, the letter, when you recited a seen, it will be completely different than صاد. So we say, فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ Continue.
فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ
إِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ
فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِن تَوَلَّيْتُمْ تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَتُقَطِّعُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها
ما شاء الله يا ريان بارك الله فيك حسبك جزاك الله خيرا we have brother عبد المعين from the KSA السلام عليكم
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله
Welcome to the program, Akhi. From ayah number 20, please, of Surat Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا.
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأطمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها إن الذين ارتدوا على أدبارهم من بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى الشيطان سول لهم وأملى لهم ذلك بأنهم قالوا للذين كرهوا ما نزل الله سنطيعكم في بعض الأمر والله يعلم إسراركم صدق الله العظيم
والله يعلم إسرارهم أحسبك جزاك الله خيرا عبد المعين beautiful recitation of course nice articulation points alhamdulillah just keep in mind that not because I want to present the Quran in a melodious voice I exceed the limit of the ghunnah for instance such as when I say إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِنَّ الَّذِينَ that's noon مُشَدَّدَة so there is a ghunnah two counts or فَإِذَا أُنزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ that's ghunnah again okay because of the إخفاء how many counts عمر the ghunnah one two طيب when I say إِنَّ الَّذِينَ ارْتَدُّوا عَلَى أَدَبَارِهِمْ that's how many counts So once two, once four, once three. Try to adhere to two. The ghunna is only two counts. Assalamu alaikum. Sister Layla from Nigeria. Abdul Ma'in, beautiful recitation, mashallah. Assalamu alaikum, Sister Layla from Nigeria. Please try again. I highly admire Nigerian Muslims and the viewers of Huda TV from Nigeria, they are in millions, mashallah. And whenever I meet any of them, I see the true love of Islam in their eyes, on their tongues, and in their hearts. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless them. But unfortunately, the signal is not reaching many parts of Nigeria recently. May Allah make it easy for us to broadcast all over the world. Allahumma ameen. Did we finish with you, Omar?
No?
Yet. Okay, continue then.
أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا
إن الذين ارتدوا على أدبارهم من بعد ما تبين لهم الهدى الشيطان سول لهم وأملى لهم ذلك بأنهم قالوا للذين كرهوا ما نزل الله سنطيعكم في بعض الأمر
فاتن الطاء سنطيعكم
سنطيعكم في بعض الأمر والله يعلم إسرارهم
حسبك بارك الله فيك يا عمر جزاك الله خيرا يوسف from Libya السلام عليكم brother يوسف
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته
Welcome to the program. Where are you from originally, Yusuf?
You said?
Where?
I'm calling from Libya.
Correct. Where are you from originally?
I'm Ghana.
From Ghana. Okay.
Yes.
May Allah protect you guys there in Libya. Go ahead and recite from ayah number 20 of Surat Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم ويقول الذين آمنوا
Okay. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عصيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها
ما شاء الله حسبك brother Yusuf جزاك الله خيرا calling from Libya and originally from Ghana بارك الله فيكم we have sister Layla back from Nigeria on the line السلام عليكم
عليكم السلام
go ahead sister and recite from ayah number 20 please
آية
نمبر 20 ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أنزلت سورة محكمة وذكر فيها القتال رأيت الذين في قلوبهم مرض ينظرون إليك نظر المغشي عليه من الموت فأولى لهم طاعة وقول معروف فإذا عزم الأمر فلو صدقوا الله لكان خيرا لهم فهل عسيتم إن توليتم أن تفسدوا في الأرض وتقطعوا أرحامكم أولئك الذين لعنهم الله فأصمهم وأعمى أبصارهم أفلا يتدبرون القرآن أم على قلوب أقفالها
حسبك sister Layla from Nigeria ما شاء الله very proud of you may Allah bless you and your family Fahim ريدي
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم ويقول الذين آمنوا لولا نزلت سورة فإذا أُزِّلَتْ سُورَةٌ مُحْكَمَةٌ وَذُكِرَ فِيهَا الْقِتَالُ رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَيْكَ نَظَرَ الْمَغْشِيِّ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْمَوْتِ فَأَغْلَى لَهُمْ طَاعَةٌ وَقَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ.
We'll just pause and take this call, inshallah. Sister Amina from United Arab Emirates.
Hello,
wa alaikum salam wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Would you please continue from ayah number 22? فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ.
Sorry, Sheikh, I can't hear you.
Go ahead and recite.
25.
Go ahead and recite even from the beginning, from ayah number 20.
Okay, sorry.
وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا
أَعُوذُ مِنَ الشَّيْطَانِ الرَّجِيمِ وَيَقُولُ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا لَوْلَا نُزِّلَتْ سُورَةٌ فَإِذَا أُنْزِلَتْ سُورَةٌ مُحْكَمَةٌ وَذُكِرَ فِيهَا الْقِتَالُ وَذُكِرَ فِيهَا الْقِتَالُ رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ رَأَيْتَ الَّذِينَ فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ مَرَضٌ يَنْظُرُونَ إِلَيْكَ نَظَرَ الْمَغْشِيِّ عَلَيْهِ مِنَ الْمَوْتِ فَأَوْلَى لَهُمْ طَاعَةٌ وَقَوْلٌ مَعْرُوفٌ فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ فَلَوْ صَدَقَ اللَّهُ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ.
فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ
فَإِذَا عَزَمَ الْأَمْرُ فَلَوْ صَدَقُوا اللَّهَ لَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُمْ فَهَلْ عَسَيْتُمْ إِنْ تَوَلَّيْتُمْ أَنْ تُفْسِدُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ وَتُقَطِّعُوا أَرْحَامَكُمْ أُولَئِكَ الَّذِينَ لَعَنَهُمُ اللَّهُ فَأَصَمَّهُمْ وَأَعْمَى أَبْصَارَهُمْ أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ أَمْ عَلَى قُلُوبٍ أَقْفَالُهَا.
حَسْبُكْ سِسْتَرْ Amina from United Arab Emirates. By that, brothers and sisters, we've just come to the end of today's edition of your program, Correct Your Recitation. I thank you all for joining us, Izzat and Umar, Ibrahim and Fahim. I still remember your name. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala bless you all and all the viewers. May Allah make us from Ahlul Quran, alladhina hum Ahlullahi wa khassatu. Aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Brothers and sisters, to increase your iman, read the miracle, recite the Quran. Recite it every day and do read it loud. The verses of Quran are all Muslims' pride. This miracle was revealed over a long time span. Sent from Allah to an angel, then to a man. That man was Muhammad, the best of creation. We were chosen to be part of his nation. He gave us a message, and that was Islam. So read this miracle, recite the Quran.